हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। माई सेल्फ राकेश यादव रिप्रेजेंटिंग सांदीपनि हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल राजोदा, एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग क्लास 12th रिलेटेड मैथ्स टॉपिक चैप्टर 6, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ डेरिवेटिव्स विच इज नोन एज AOD, एंड वी आर ऑन एक्सरसाइज 6.3 अप टू क्वेश्चन 5th वी हैव डन इन आवर प्रीवियस पार्ट। नाउ वी आर डिस्कसिंग क्वेश्चन 6th, फाइंड द स्लोप ऑफ द नॉर्मल टू द कर्व x इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस ए साइन थीटा एंड y इज इक्वल टू b कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा एट थीटा इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय 2। So, in solution, given, what is given here? X is equal to 1 minus a sin theta and y is equal to b cos square theta. So, first of all, we have to find dx by d theta and dy by d theta because both are functions of theta only. So, on differentiating with respect to theta, what we will get? Dx by d theta is equal to 0 because differentiation of 1 is 0, minus a into d by d theta of sine theta, and dy by d theta is equal to b d by d theta of cos square theta. So now dx by d theta is equal to minus a cos theta and dy by d theta will be equal to 2b cos theta. First of all, why is it so? Because we are considering cos theta as t, so t square differentiation is 2t, but it is not t, it is cos theta. So we have to differentiate this cos theta again with respect to theta. So now dy by d theta is equal to what? Dy by d theta is equal to minus 2b sin theta cos theta. Now we may write dy by dx. So according to chain rule, what will be dy by dx? Dy by dx will be equal to dy by d theta upon dx by d theta by chain rule. So, now we can put value of dy by d theta and dx by d theta. So, it will be dy by dx is equal to, what is value of dy by d theta? That is minus 2b sin theta cos theta upon minus a cos theta, minus a cos theta. So, this cos theta will be cancelled. And this minus sign will also be cancelled. So dy by dx is equal to 2b upon a sin theta. So slope of tangent dy by dx at theta is equal to what? Theta is equal to pi by 2, which is given to us. So it will be equal to 2b upon a into sine 90 degree. Sine pi by 2 value is 1. So it will be equal to 2b upon a. This will be equal to 2b upon a because sine 90 degree value is 1. So this is the slope of tangent. Now it is not required to us. What is required to us? Find the slope of the normal. So, for determining slope of the normal, what we have to do? Slope of normal is equal to minus 1 upon slope of tangent. So, we can say that this will become reciprocal because it is in upon. So what will be our final answer? It will be minus a upon 2b because it is in the denominator, that slope of the tangent. So reciprocal of 2b upon a will be a upon 2b, and minus sign is also there. So final answer is minus a upon 2b for our question number 6. So this question 6 is now over. Now see, it is question number 7. Find the points at which the tangent to the curve y is equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 9x plus 7 is parallel to x-axis. See, in solution, we have to write given equation of curve y is equal to x cube minus 3x square minus 9x plus 7. So, on differentiating with respect to x, what will happen? Dy by dx is equal to 3x square minus 6x minus 9. We may differentiate it. X cube differentiation is 3x square. X square differentiation is 2x. So, 2x into 3 is 6x. And then differentiation of x is 1. So, minus 9 into 1 will be equal to minus 9. So, dy by dx is equal to 3x square minus 6x minus 9. Because tangent is parallel to x-axis, therefore, dy by dx is equal to what? Dy by dx is always equal to 0 when it is parallel to x-axis. Jab tangent x-axis ke parallel hota hai, tab dy by dx ki value 0 ke barabar rakhni hoti hai. Means what we have to find here now? We have to write this dy by dx, that is 3x square minus 6x minus 9 equal to 0. Then 3 will be taken common. So, it will be x square minus 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, or this will become 0 upon 3 in RHS. So, it will be equal to x square minus 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. Now, in product what we need? Minus 3. So, minus 3 into plus 1 is minus 3, and minus 3 plus 1 is equal to minus 2. So, it can be broken in this form, x square minus 3x plus 1x minus 3 is equal to 0. See, minus 3x plus 1x is minus 2x, and minus 3 into plus 1 is minus 3. So, x is taken common, so it will be x minus 3, and plus 1 is taken common, then it will be x minus 3 again is equal to 0. So, x minus 3 is now taken common. So, remaining part is x plus 1, it is equal to 0. So, what is the value of x? X is equal to 3 and x is equal to minus 1. On putting in equation 1, if we put these values of x in equation 1, then what will be the value of y? Y is equal to 3 cube minus 3 into 3 square minus 9 into 3 plus 7, and y is equal to minus 1 cube minus 3 into minus 1 square, and then minus 9 into minus 1, and then plus 7. So, after solving this, y is equal to 27 minus 27 minus 27 plus 7. So, this 27 and 27 will be cancelled out. Y is equal to minus 20. So, what is this point? 3 comma minus 20. If we are putting 3, then we are getting y minus 20. If we are putting value of x minus 1, then what we will get y? So, y is equal to minus 1, because minus 1 cube means it is odd number. So, negative value having power odd number means result will be negative. Minus 1 square is positive 1. Minus 1 square is positive 1. So, positive 1 is when multiplied by negative 3, then it will be negative 3. Minus into minus will become plus 9 on the 9 plus 7. So, it will be y is equal to what we got? 9 plus 7 is 16. 16 minus 4. 16 minus 4 is 12. So, here point having coordinates minus 1 comma 12. So what is needed? See, find the points at which the tangent to the curve this is parallel to x-axis. So points are, finally we can conclude, points are, which are the points? 3 comma minus 20 and minus 1 comma 12. Means ये वो दो points हैं जहां पर अगर हम tangent खींचते हैं तो वो tangent parallel होगा x axis के. What we have to do here? If it is given parallel to x axis, then we have to write dy by dx is equal to 0. अगर ये slope is parallel, sorry, normal is parallel to x axis होता है या parallel to y axis होता है, sorry, अगर ये parallel to y axis होता है तो in that case what you have to write, normal is, means sorry, slope of normal will be equal to 0. जब ये y axis के parallel होता है तब हम क्या लिखते हैं, जब tangent y axis के parallel होता है तो हम लिखते हैं slope of normal is equal to 0. तो स्लोप ऑफ नॉर्मल इज इक्वल टू जीरो मतलब क्या हो जाएगा, वन के अपॉन में ये पूरा लिख करके माइनस वन साइन लगा के माइनस के अपॉन माइनस वन के अपॉन में डी वाई बाई डी एक्स की वैल्यू रख करके उसको इक्वल टू जीरो लिखते हैं जब पैरेलल टू वाई एक्सिस होता है तब. लेकिन पैरेलल टू एक्स एक्सिस में सीधे डी वाई बाई डी एक्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो पुट करना होता है. दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 इज नाउ ओवर. नाउ सी, इट इज क्वेश्चन 8. फाइंड अ पॉइंट ऑन द कर्व y is equal to x minus 2 whole square at which the tangent is parallel to the chord joining the point 2, 0 and 4, 4. So, in solution, let us find out first of all slope of chord, or we can say what it is, slope of chord. Slope of chord is equal to y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. And we are assigning it m1. Suppose ये slope of chord मैंने लिखा, that you know this formula. This formula you know from class 11th, that it is the line which is joining this point and this point. Then how to find out the slope? y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So 4 minus 0 upon 4 minus 2. So m1 is equal to what? 4 upon 2, that is equal to 2. So m1 is equal to 2. Now slope, before writing slope of tangent, let us write curve. Equation of curve, what it is? Equation of curve is equal to, is equation of curve is y is equal to x minus 2 whole square. So slope of tangent is equal to what? Dy by dx, you know it very well, dy by dx. So it will be equal to d by dx of x minus 2 whole square. Now what we have to do? We have to differentiate it. Suppose I am considering it t. So differentiation of t square is 2t. So it will be dy by dx is equal to 2 into x minus 2. Now we have to differentiate x minus 2 again. So d by dx of x minus 2. Of course it is 1 because differentiation of x is 1. Differentiation of negative 2 is 0. So it will be dy by dx is equal to 2 into x minus 2. It is slope of tangent. So because tangent is parallel to chord, it is given in our question. See, find a point on the curve at which the tangent is parallel to the chord. So tangent is parallel to chord. Therefore, suppose I am assigning it m2. मान लीजिए मैंने इसको m2 नाम दिया स्लोप ऑफ टेंजेंट को. इसको मैंने क्या नाम दिया? m2. तो m2 is equal to ये हो गया. So that's why these are parallel. So what is the condition for parallel? m1 is equal to m2. कंडीशन फॉर परपेंडिकुलर इज m1 m2 इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन एंड कंडीशन फॉर पैरेलल इज m2 इज इक्वल टू m1 और m1 इज इक्वल टू m2. सो m2 इज इक्वल टू m1 आई एम राइटिंग. इट इज द कंडीशन फॉर पैरेलल. सो स्लोप्स आर इक्वल इन कंडीशन ऑफ पैरेलल. सो m2 इज इक्वल टू m1 मीन्स वॉट 2 इंटू x माइनस 2 विल बी इक्वल टू वॉट इज वैल्यू ऑफ m1 m1 इज 2. सो x माइनस 2 is equal to 2 upon 2, that will be equal to 1. So x minus 2 is equal to 1. So x is equal to 3. If x is equal to 3, then we can put this value 3 there in first equation. What is our equation first? It is first equation. On putting in equation 1. If we put this value in equation 1, then y will be equal to 3 minus 2 whole square, that is equal to 1. So coordinates of point, or point is, what is point? Point is, what is our point? 3 comma 1 is that particular point where the curve's tangent is parallel to this particular chord. So this question number 8 is now over, and thanks a lot for watching our channel Sandipani Higher Secondary School Rajoda. Please do like it, subscribe it and share it, and please do study also.